Hello everyone. Yes, today I didn't prepare anything. I'm busy with my other works. Anyhow, let's start with yesterday's. Yesterday I mentioned that today we'll be discussing about I not even prepared slide, so just image, still slide is undergoing on. So today we are going to discuss about how to write a script, like a script demo I'll be showing now. Also I'll discuss about how to contribute and how to learn Python on your own. So let me start with the question. Everyone might have, most of the participants, you might have received email or through WhatsApp for the registration. In registration, I have asked a few questions, like your name and email, organization, and which course would you like to attend, like a Python 5 hours, a CDAT and IRS 5 hours. And I have received responses till 149. Afterwards, I just stopped the responses. And I have a few like summaries. This is Google form, like all 149 names are there. Like in terms of questions, like I can go to like a, if I want to know what is organization, like from NSMRW of 36 response, and IIT Delhi 13 response, and IITD, same IIT Delhi, but a different characters in terms of strings, 8 response, and HPE, similarly IIT Delhi 7 response, and NSMRWF at where N is a capital, others are small characters, that's a 6 response, and students 5, and somebody mentioned like Indian Institute of Technology Delhi, 2 response, and Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, 2 response. IITD, where I is the capital and rest are small character. Likewise, we have received so many responses. So let's frame the question. Like if suppose my head is asking, like I have used paid version of Zoom and free version of YouTube classes to take this 10 days classes. And I'm sure he will ask, tell me how many people are registered from NSMRWF, or how many of them from IITM, or how many of them from IIT Delhi, or rest of the institute. Like a few people even from Nigerian Meteorological Agency. So I can't go through these individually and then make like a count, or I have note down in paper. So this is tedious job. So what we are going to do? I have response, these responses I received in the Google Sheet. Here I just deleted the email column of your email column, not visible to the YouTube or even the Zoom people. So just the name and organization are visible here, and the response through like either Python or Python and CDAT both. So we can see like 140, like 149 responses are there. I already mentioned like even just if you take only NCMRWF, like a different character people used to write. Like NCMRWF, see it here, FMS and NCMRWF. See this kind of character. So we can't go with the like a manual work just to get how many people from NCMRWF or how many of them from IIT Delhi or other group. So we are going to write, I'm going to write a script to sort out this and to group together, like only listing out the individual organization people. I want to display the names of the participant of individual groups. So through Python program, I'm going to do this. So let me download this as a CSV file. comma separated value. So in day 5, I have downloaded this. Let me open the day 5. So in day 5, so this is CSV file. Let me open it to Atom. I think, yeah, so this is the response which I downloaded in terms of CSV file. So everything is a comma separated value, that's what we used to call CSV. So first line is like timestamp, name, email, I'll just make sure that I download the correct one. Yeah, correct. Okay, so it starts with this timestamp and name. Then MT1, then like institute, say institute. So I'm going to grab this, the third column. Like a 0th is the timestamp and 1st is the name. And 2nd is that a email ID which I deleted. So it's coming with the empty column and then institute name like this, NCMRWF. So I'm going to grab or let me close this. Yes. So I'm going to write a script for this. Sorry. Sometimes my system make trouble because I'm sharing both Zoom and YouTube together. Let me open it. Yeah, it's just open. So first I'm importing whatever stuff I wanted. I'll be using this. I think only OS is sufficient. Let me open it. So I'm just copying the file name. I just stored it. I'm going to get the all the lines within that program, sorry, within that CSV file, whatever it is there. I'm just storing the lines. What I'm going to do, get the line. So I got all the lines. So I'm reading in the lines, like I'm just opening and then open dot read lines, which will produce the, it will read all the lines into a list. Then I'm going to loop through in the list. There I'm going to split the line. Better to store it. I'm just stored the lines. Then I'm looping it here. I'm splitting it with comma. So once I split into comma, then this will be another response, another, it will produce another set of lines. Like it will be a multiple list. So once I have done this, then I can go with so the first name would be like a timestamp that I'm omitting. The next is the name. And third is the email, which also I'm omitting, then institute. This I want to collect it. Just write more simple way so that you people understand it. So the first one is first one is date stamp and second is name. So this is the second, then institute. That's a 0, 1, and 2 is email ID, which I already deleted. And then this third is the institute. And I have already collected the details. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to write down this into one dictionary. So you can initialize the dictionary with the empty parentheses. This will become empty dictionary. So in the institute, we have seen like a different names. So how I'm going to sort out, the first thing I'm going to make it as upper one. So the smaller also will merge with the upper one. So I can assign a institute to the dictionary. Then I can add I didn't get much time to teach you more functionality in the dictionary, but you can explore yourself. So what I'm doing it here, if this key is not in this dictionary, right now dictionary is empty, my dictionary is empty. So if this key is not in institute, then I am adding this key. then I'm adding with the empty list. Then I'm adding the name. I'm appending this name to the empty list. I can print only the keys also. Let me see whether this program is working or not. Oh, great, it works. So we can see that you can count the length of dictionary also. It is 58, 58 institute registered. I hope some of them duplicate. Still, we are going to merge it, remove the duplicates. Like one NCMR of here, and again it is become NCM, like some people made some mistake, NCMWF, and it has become with one single quote also. So what can we do? So this institute, so I have names, suppose this institute, if this institute contains character NCM, just start with NCM, then I'll replace this with NCMRWF. I can go with even multiple. Right, let me check this whether it works or not. So it didn't work. I can use starts with. See this, now it's reduced from 58 to 56, it has reduced, which means two duplicates have been removed, but still this one duplication is there with somehow it returns with starts with double character. Some error, like mistakes here. I should made one more. So now it becomes 55. So then finally I'm going to merge with this one. National Center for Medium Range. So I'll just mention with the national also. So now it become 52. Then other common or IIT Delhi. So that also we'll fix it. Then with that we can freeze this demo work. We can write LF. So now it has become 50. Then I in the Institute of Tropical Meteorology also have duplicate. And somebody has still, yeah, in the Institute of Technology Delhi also there. So this also we can fix it. Similar to this, there is something called ends with also, so that also we can use it. Okay, we can do the reverse search also, like if Delhi Institute. Now it has become 47. Yes. Then this also I'll finish it in Chamarabalia. One more duplicate is there. Instead of like this, then I can write two line also. Like you can put R condition also. So in Python, we do have AND condition and OR condition. So now it becomes 44. So finally one IATM and metrology, I'll just merge with that. With that we can freeze it. Charge. show it. So far we have 44. Oh, this is not reduced. Insert. Now it become 42. So I think there are no more duplicates available. So in the registration, we can see that. We can see that there are 42 different institutes are registered with for these live demo classes. So now I'm going to store individually the names or participants of their names with respect to their institute. I'm going to write down into separate files. So I'm just accessing through institute. So I'm right now, this is institute. This mydic.institute. Yeah, I can do institute and what? We can use the dictionary iter items. This that will return both key and its value. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open new file with institute. So this institute name having some spaces also, that spaces I'm going to replace with the hyphen. The single space being replaced with the hyphen. Also, then I'm going to write down into TXT file. Just happened in the TXT file. I'm opening write mode. So I'm just look through the names. I'm write down the name. Plus, I'm just adding the new line. So all the names will be with the new line, will be added with the new line character. See, this demo 5 folder, it contains only demo.py, which we are writing currently, and then the CSV file. I'm going to execute this program again. Yes, it is written many institute, but somebody mentioned NA institute. In file, we can't write with the slash. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to replace that. I'm getting trouble in accessing my editor because of this Zoom share and YouTube share. Just wait a few minutes. Yeah, here. So this also I just replaced. So now everything is written. Like it shows that this file being written, these files, like starts with IIT Bhubaneswar .txt. So one people from IIT, one person from IIT Bhubaneswar and HPE2. So we can see that Guru Nanak from one, Cray one, Home one, Cray. See this in day 5, we can see that these many files are just created right now. See this fellow from, so I'm just not exposing much of the privacy. I'll just go with our institute, like NCMRWF. Like we can see that, 55 people registered from NCMRWF. So good to see. And rest of them from other institute, say for NCOIS, one scientist from NCMRWF 55 and NCES. So likewise from Nigerian, we have one, yeah. So what I'll do, I'll just I'm just going to remove. I'm just deleting these txt files. So again, I'll just run it to avoid confusion. So there are 42 different institutes registered for this Python-like course. We can get their counts. How many people are registered? So from IIT Delhi, 36. I'm missing. Yeah, then NCMRWF 55. So if you want to just to print the institute name with the descending order, for that also we can write. So once we have generated the dictionary, then you can do whatever operation you want to do. So so far in this program, I'll just a little go through that. I'm going to write the extra program in this. So let me just explain it. So first here I'm opening the CSV file, the first like line number 3. I didn't use this so far, this important system. But if suppose if you want to open the CSV file from other location, then we have to use this OS command, os.path.join, or locate to locate the absolute path of the CSV file. Then here I'm just opening, and then immediately I'm just reading it, read lines. So this is returning all the CSV lines into this lines object. So then what I'm doing, I'm each line containing a comma separated value that I'm splitting. This yesterday or day before yesterday, I showed you how to write a single line for loop. So using the for loop, I'm just making a list. These individual line are splitted by the comma separated. So this is returning yet another list. So it's containing multiple list, this line one. Then here I'm initializing with my dictionary. Just a dictionary I'm initializing with the empty parentheses. Then I'm loop throughing with the lines, line one, which contain list of list, that individual list having multiple elements. So through index I'm accessing, the first one is name, then third index is institute. I'm just making upper to reduce duplicate, but still we are identified few duplicates that's can be sorted out through manual. So using our own identification, I just kept these. If institute start with any one of these, then it will go inside this condition, the statement. Or if NCMRWF inside institute. So in any case, it will be assigned just institute. Similarly for like IIT Delhi or multiple choice, similar to the same institute being assigned to the same, single institute. If suppose institute ends with IITM or metrology, Indian Institute of Metrology, so that being assigned to IITM. So finally, what I'm doing it here, if institute, that keyword not in my dictionary, then I'm assigning that dictionary, that key into the dictionary with the assignment of just empty list. So once it is done, so what I'm doing it here, my dictionary of key, that's my dictionary, the key is institute that I'm assigning it here and just appending. So this list will be keep on expanding with the name. So whoever belongs to this particular institute, that name will be expanded or appended. So that we have seen already, the my dictionary being generated. So once it is generated, again, what I'm going to do here, just for institute names, this could be like any variable name in my dictionary iter items. So you can access this my dictionary my dict.keys. That's a function that will return only a list of keys. Similarly, values is there. It will just return values. Instead of that, I'm just itering it both keys and value. So introduce key and names is the value. So here what I'm doing, just I'm replacing that institute. It's a string with empty spaces. Empty spaces are being replaced with the hyphen. Then I'm just adding .txt. Again, later on we found one of the institute having slash. So I'm just slash also being replaced with the hyphen. And finally, I'm just opening just one object, just OIF is equal to open or file with the institute name and then opening in the write mode. Then what I'm doing here for name in names, this names is here, which containing the list of names belongs to a particular institute. I'm writing down their name, then plus with a new line. If you are not appending new line, everything will become in a single line. So that's hard to read in that text file. So this will be written all the names into particular, all the names of a particular institute being written into this institute file name, institute.txt. Finally, I'm closing it here. Just printing here, return institute that this file name will be returned. And then also I'm just counting like a length of names. This is what we have seen it here. Like how many people are. This further you can we can enhance in terms like appending or listing out incremental order or descending order, which institute registered more people. So in this similar way only I have I wrote the script to send the email. So even today also you might have received the email. Those who received the email, that's I sent through the program, through the Python program. So I just used to define the subject and body, then mail body, and then sending individual mails, reading those mail from this CSV file, composing mail, sending mail to individually through them. So let me go and it's already 4:50. I just want to conclude today's session. Just download my presentations. Just give me some time. Yes, it's day 5. So I have 5 minutes. In 5 minutes, I will complete the classes. Somebody asked how to make classes. Class also, it's very easy. You can just define class and class name. The class name start with a capital name, capital letter. The first character must be capital. And once you define the class, and within the class, you can define the methods. So here P is the object. Object is equal to that class name. So using this P, like here we are defining the methods, class and methods. Self is the first argument. It's a mandatory. Then here I'm just creating P object. P is equal to person. Then P dot say hi. So like this, we can access the methods. So this is a small introduction about the class and objects. We will conduct one more session for the class, detailed class. We will intimate you. So now I'm skipping the class. I'll just go through the remaining slides with the shorts. What all things can be done using Python? We can do database integration, like we can connect to the database. Like what are the database you know, like PostgreSQL or MySQL, whatever SQL you have, we can connect through Python. We can write queries, database queries in Python itself. This is just another demo. And how to learn it? As we already shown that interactive Python, instance response, LAN as you type. You have to type it so that you can learn by yourself. In these shells, we can use bpython or ipython shells. And Python can communicate with other languages. So C plus Python. Can you guess what could be the name? Cython. So there is a library called Cython. You can interact between Python and C programming language. Yes, Java plus Python, Zython. So we can install the Zython, and if you know Java and if you want to utilize Java within Python, you can go with that. Similarly for Fortran also there is something called F2Py, and for R language also there, R2Py. So you can install those packages and you can access R or Fortran inside your Python. Moreover, we can create a graphical user interface with the Python. These are all few packages, Qt, GTK, WXPython. With these three, you can create, like a WXPython is a cross-platform GUI library. You can create a GUI, that's a GUI programming. Once you created, that will be cross-platform, across any platform like Mac, Linux, Windows, Android, you can install it and that will be executed. The graphical interface. And a ton of the libraries are there. Like with this combination, Glade, Python, GTK, you can easily create. This is the Glade template where you can drag and drop your GUI template. And backend, you can write the script that will produce this kind of GUI programming. Also, web development is there. In Python, it's a Django framework. There are multiple framework. One of them is a Django. And those who know that NCMRW recently released the website for the data access that is designed in Django. And further, if you want to learn, you can go to the website python.org. You'll get more details about the current Python versions. There are books on Python. If you want to learn physical books like a paper book, you can go with this, beginning with Python, programming with Python, dive into Python. Dive into Python is very much, much more detailed. And all these books are available in internet, free of cost. PDF would be there, you can download and you can exercise yourself. And if you have any questions, you can come to that place right now. And anytime you can write your questions to us, you know our mail IDs. Let me go to question session. So please come down to question session. It seems nobody have any doubt. So I think today class nobody understands, so that's why nobody asking questions. It's fine. So in the question session, I already mentioned the day one, day two, day three, day four presentation links. And today's also will be uploaded. And yesterday somebody asked like this source code should be available in GitHub or not. We already pushed till yesterday's source code into the GitHub. The link also we have given. One moment.
Let me know.
Question open. Also, we made some feedback form. So kindly go through the feedback form and give feedback so that the upcoming session will be improved in terms of our speaking style or the volume, or the setup style. Let me reload once again. Check. I told ask questions in the many times. I told ask questions in this forum, not in the chat. Let me open. Somebody asked questions in the chat. So many people asked questions in this forum. The Zoom one. Oh, somebody mentioned not audible. Okay, fine then. Okay, somebody asked, I'm getting confused. What if we have large data set? Is there a way to extract all repeated strings order then virtual check? Yes, we can use set command to avoid the duplicates. So if you have used set command, it will reduce the duplicates. But the thing is, if we have proper duplicates, then it's easy. Just uppercase, lowercase, then easily we can identify. But if somebody return like in Simar Bolia, some of them return National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting. So this kind of abbreviation that we have to do it manually. At least we should write the program to tell that these are all coming under both common institute. This contain, don't we have contain function instead of start with, ends with? That's what I wrote it in function. Like this, in Delhi in institute. So this is what similar question which you asked. Yes, NCMWF, that is there. Only NCMWF is there, NCM, because we made with the NCM, start with NCM, then that also will be treated as NCMWF. Yeah, somebody mentioned that the PyGrads is there. Py3Grads and PyGrads is there. Those who wish to use grads in Python, you can use it. So pad Mozilla network means you have to reload it. So already it's 5. So again, I'll share the feedback form. Feedback form I already listed in a YouTube stream as of now. Also, pad.mozilla. Here also I mentioned feedback form. So kindly give feedback. So that will give encourage to Mrs. Mahalakshmi. So she'll be interested to get more feedback. So the next classes also she'll take. So it's a 5. I hope you all of you enjoyed the Python session. So I'm expecting more Python programmers among these live classes, whoever watching in YouTube or later on watching the YouTube recorded videos, as well as the Zoom participants. I mentioned that how to contribute. I forget to mention that. So whatever code we have written yesterday and the day before yesterday, here we have uploaded in GitHub. GitHub is the platform where you can share your source code. One of the platform is the GitHub. Git is the command used to for like using Git, you can do the version control. Like a subversion is there, similar to that, Git is there. That's the version control. Using this version control tool, that's called GitHub. It is launched and maintained by the Linus Torvalds, who is the kind of inventor of Linux. So here you can come and create your own account. Then you can create a repository, code repository, where you can load, you can upload only the code, not the output. Text files, you can upload it. Here we mentioned day one, day two, day three, day four, where you can go and get the source code. We didn't rename anything. So whatever the source code we made it and record in YouTube, the same thing we coded. So this way also you can contribute back to the community. Suppose if you're a system admin or if you're a scientist, you may be doing some problem solving using Python code. That code also you can contribute back to the community. This everything be hosted in the open license. So similar way you can do it. Let me open mine. So contribution is most important. If you're not contributing back, then it will not grow. So somebody might, many people are contributed back to the Python. That's why the Python is sustaining so far. And in all the field, it is being utilized. So here also I used to do many contribution. Like you no need to go to some community and then do the contribution. You can take your own problem and solve it. That solution you can put it in your own repository. So somebody might be coming through that and they can utilize it. Like I have some 46 repos. So that everything is there. You can go through it and you can fork down others repository also. You can fork down in your GitHub and watch it. So contribution is most essential. We should not be just a seeker of somebody else's time, and we should give back. Like we should be a giver. So write down whatever the source code you are writing, whatever solution you are making yourself, that make it as a public. So others will not do the reinventing the wheel. We no need to waste our time as well as others' time. So whatever you are making your own solution, give it back. If you are more encouraged to do in terms of contribution, like you can go to any repository, the existing repository, like this is one of the existing repository, which I'll be talking tomorrow onwards, see that. Climate data analysis tool. So the you can take that kind of repository and then you can do your own contribution, and it will be, they will be accepting some of the CDAT climate data analysis tool. From tomorrow onwards, I'll be discussing about more detail about this. So I also contributed to this one. few of them. So similarly, other institute also there, like our own institute, NCMRWF. Here we do have a few of the repositories. So we are welcoming you to contribute back whatever solutions you are making for your own itches. So kindly give feedback here. I already mentioned the links in the YouTube channel as well as here. Yeah, 1 second, just sharing this in the chat. So I once again thank for today's session. Last 5 days, a Python session has gone viral in YouTube. There are more than 700 views for the first day, but second day onwards it's reduced, but it's okay. And tomorrow again, once again, we will meet. We'll learn about climate data analysis tool. And if those who are watching in YouTube, please subscribe channel so that you'll get a notification for the future classes, the live streams. Thank you.